Look, I'm not the type of guy with an axe to grind. First off, my family isn't in the lumber industry, and second, I prefer swords. But I think it's safe to say we all have something really petty we dislike about other people. Not altruistically or morally, but something benign and stupid. Maybe it's a hairstyle or a fashion statement. A fad or a trend you don't really click with. For me, it's lanyards. Lanyards make me irrationally angry. No, I'm not talking about lanyards around your neck, however. Those ones are pretty cool. But the ones attached to car keys. Anyone who's ever been to an American high school knows what I'm talking about. Some 16-year-old just got their license and they want everyone to know it. So what do they spend their meagerly McDonald's blood money paycheck on? A goddamn lanyard. These people want you to notice it. And if you're watching the video right now and you have a lanyard, I know what you're up to. Scheming as the lanyard dangles from your pocket. A tantalizing invitation for someone to snag the keys of your parents' beat-up 1991 Honda Civic. The lanyard has no tactical use other than being a fashion statement, if you could even call it that. Like, what if you passed by a rogue paper shredder? Look who's reenacting the ending of Incredibles 1 syndrome. Lanyards are a liability and should be treated as such. If I was an insurance salesman and I saw my client with a disgusting lanyard slithering out of their pocket, I would end all business relations with that person. How could you use something not intended for its original purpose?
What?
You know what's even worse? People swing around their lanyards like the blades of a combat helicopter, endangering the lives of others with their razor-sharp keys on the end. It's a proven fact that lanyards cause over 273 deaths every year. Granted, most if not all of these deaths were due to a variety of circumstances not related to lanyards, such as heart failure, rock climbing stairs, and vending machines, but the point still stands. A lanyard was involved in some way, shape, or form, whether the person had it in their pocket, or it was in the room somehow. Now you may call me a straw man, which I must tell you is a very offensive term, as I have a good friend that's a scarecrow. Would a straw man make a shallow argument and use only anecdotal evidence to bolster their faulty claims? No, because yet again, that is a stereotype that people use to discredit others like my good friend, Jimmy the Scarecrow!
You know what? I'm tired of these maniacs running around, disturbing the public and flaunting their hedonistic ways. It's time to go lanyard hunting.
Okay, I found a prime spot to snag some lanyards. A place ripe for the picking.
I see that goober over there? He has a lanyard right on his hip.
This is Bravo Red to Delta King. Can you read me? I got my eyes on the prize. It's time for the diversion. Go, go! That's the signal.
Come in.
Ha-ha!
Wait a second.
Oh, hey man, I accidentally got your wallet.
Yeah, can I get my wallet back?
Yeah, sure. Yeah,
wait,
thanks.
Hold up.
You fool! I will redeem you of your sins.
Why didn't you help, man?
Jeez, it's hot.
No, you're not supposed to be in the... You're not supposed to be in the frame, King. Ow, my knee! It's all...